held in 787. That's not 1977, that's not 1897, 87. So imagine there's 267 bishops coming from all over the world, and they have their deacons and their friends and all these people, and they're trotting away, getting to Nicaea. They hopefully were there at the first one. This is the second one in Nicaea. So they arrived, and the reason for the council was these icons that we still have with us today. There were a group of people that thought that these icons were idols. And they convinced the church and many followers that they should all be destroyed. And many of them were. Many of them were taken down from churches. Many of them were defiled. Many of them were gone. And you see some of that in modern day life today, right? You see things that other radical groups are doing to temples and to cherished items. So it's still happening today. But what was put to rest for the Orthodox Church was, these are not idols. We're not worshiping the wood. We're not worshiping the paint. We're not worshiping the cross. What we're doing is we're asking the saints, or who was ever depicted, or whatever events depicted in the idol, we're asking them to intercede for us. We're praying through the icon to God. These are depictions of angels and martyrs and prophets that are closer to God and they can intercede for us. Some of them have special inclinations or special healing powers that have been recorded as prophets. So that was the reason for the Seventh Ecumenical Council. The decision was that they were not idols. So we are still here honoring and praying. And it's funny, we've all probably been to different churches, Presbyterian churches and Catholic churches, and sometimes you can see like little bits of icons still left on the walls, still over in a corner there might be one that, icon over there. In Catholic churches they had the wave across all the way around, and those were essentially icons that are still there. In some churches they've taken them down, but if you look closely in many churches you'll see little posters of icons. Orthodox Christians, those are the things that we love. So that was the Seventh Ecumenical Council, and we celebrate that today. But as for the gospel that we had today, we're in Luke chapter 8, and it's the sower of the seed. I'm sure you've all heard it many times. It's very memorable. You can see people sowing seeds and how they can fall on the rocks and the trodden path and then the thorns. And in preparation for this sermon, I went back and I watched Father Mancus's sermon on this. And he had a different way about him, as all preachers do, but his question and call out to people, how many people are farmers here? how many people have been on a farm, and how many people grow their own vegetables? And I think as we pass through the short amount of time that we had from his sermons to today, more and more people aren't planting, right? We're just going to the store and picking up stuff. But I think we all know from either science or a class that we took, or we were watching our kids do science experiments and their videos, we know how to plant seeds, right? We know, for kids in class, they put them in a little cup and they put some soil in it and they push the seed down and they water it and they put it by the window. And they, later on in life, they learn about photosynthesis and all these things and how. So they don't fill a cup with rocks and put a seed in it and expect it to grow. You don't, just drop it in the cup with nothing in it and let it grow. Or you don't stick it in the hot sun so it's so hot that the seed burns up. And that's what Jesus was trying to get across to the disciples through that parable. But you read different depictions and different translations of this. Basically, the apostles were saying, Jesus, what does this mean? And I can only imagine that they're saying, Jesus, like, everybody knows that. Jesus, what are you talking about? Seeds. We all know that. All these people know, look, everybody grows their own food. But then he reveals to them, the seed is the word of God. Right? That's the important part. The important part about the story is the seeds are the word of God. He tells people about the different things about the seeds. If they're in the thorns, they're going to get choked, and if they're on the trodden path, they're going to get trodden. But for us, we are the fertile ground. their heart. Your heart is like a rock. It's not going to grow. But you're still getting the seed anyway, see. You've done your Christian duty to try to turn them. Some of them, they'll listen to you for a while, right? Just like the ones that fell on the path of, I heard that. I got to go now. Yeah, thanks. So we need those different types of people today, too. But friends, don't give up. And keep that seed within us. Don't get discouraged. It's easy, very easy and simple to get discouraged in this day and age. We can see it all around us. We can see through our children and our grandchildren, even ourselves. How much time do we spend with the scriptures versus how much time do we looking up something silly on our phone or watching TV? You do have to take time for yourself, for your own pleasures, to clear your mind. I'm not saying study God all day and all night, but just take some time aside.